Well, imagine being abandoned by your parents at birth. That was the awful reality of 36-year-old Jono Lancaster.
When I was born, my birth parents decided that they needed to go their way and I needed to go my way. My adoption report says that Jonathan Lancaster was born on the 31st of the 10th, 1984. Both parents were horrified by the child's appearance. Both parents felt no maternal bond. Both parents left the hospital 36 hours later, leaving the child behind.
And here to share his story is Jono, who joins us via Zoom from West Yorkshire in the UK. Good morning, Jono.
Good morning, guys. How are you doing?
Fantastic.
We're okay. God, I tell you what, though, we're both parents, and it absolutely breaks our hearts that people could leave a baby at the hospital. How old were you when you first read your adoption report, Jono?
So I've always known that I was adopted. I never ever remember sitting down with my adoptive mum and having that conversation. I've always known when I first read my adoption report and heard those lines, that was when I was around 23, 24.
Jono, what exactly is Treacher-Collins syndrome?
So Treacher-Collins affects the face. So for me, I don't have any cheekbones, so that's why my eyes droop down. My ears haven't developed properly, so I've got these little Bart Simpson ears, which I absolutely love. Obviously, the weather is pretty crappy here in the UK, and my ears don't get cold. They don't pop on flights. I wear a hearing aid, and you know, whenever my mum all the teachers used to shout at me, I always used to take my hearing aid off so I didn't have to listen to them. and that's it for my Treacher-Collins. It does affect the face. For others, he's a cute kid, isn't he?
Oh, adorable.
For others, you know, it affects their jaws, so they need a tracheostomy. Some are fed through a tube. They have difficulty breathing. But for me, it's... I guess you see it in my eyes and my ears.
Oh, it's quite amazing that you still have that fantastic sense of humour and that positivity as well. You mentioned your mum. How old were you when you were actually adopted?
So Jean, who met me in the hospital at 2 weeks old, she's always told me when she first went into the hospital, the social workers, the nurses, the doctors, they just kept on talking about my face. This boy looks different. You need to be prepared for the way he looks. And Jean, she's not even 5 foot. She's tiny. And she just didn't care. She was just so crazy excited to meet me. And she's always told me that as soon as she held me, she just felt this connection, this bond, and was like, when can I take him home? So she did it 2 weeks, and then for the next 5 years, she tried to reconnect me with my birth parents. That didn't work out. So when I was 5 years old, I was placed for adoption, and Jean was like, he's mine. Nobody's having him. So, and Jean, you know, she's a single mum, lived in a council property, didn't have a job, but she just got this massive, massive heart. And just gave me my forever family, my forever home, and I'm very, very blessed and very, very lucky to have had that opportunity.
She sounds like an angel, doesn't she? She most definitely is.
What? I can't even comprehend. What must it be like growing up with a condition like this in terms of obviously, if your parents had that reaction to it, children around, you know, everyone around your area when you're growing up, what would that have been like?
So when I was younger, I didn't realise that I was any different. I just thought I was a regular kid. And then as I started attending school and after school activities, playing football and rugby, I would notice the kids. First of all, came the stares. Then the kids would pull their eyes down or they would fold their ears over. when I went rugby training, the kids would say, oh, you can't tackle him. Don't go near him in case you catch his disease. And as I got older, it hurt more and more. And as I got older and I started having more grown-up thoughts, I'm now thinking, how am I ever going to get a job? How am I ever going to make friends? How am I ever going to get married when this is happening? And the two people that are supposed to stick by you no matter what, if they can't do it, how's anybody else going to go through it? And my mum who adopted me, she's my hero, and I'd hate to think where I'd be without her.
Oh, God.
And she always told me I was beautiful. She always told me that I could do anything that I wanted to do. But as I got older, I stopped believing my mum and started believing all those negative thoughts that I had in my head. And it was a very, very hard cycle to get out of.
Well, you said that Jean tried to get in touch with your birth parents before with no luck. Did you ever, as an adult, try to make contact with your birth parents?
Yeah, so when I was 24, I kind of had a big attitude shift, and I was very grateful for who was in my life. And I'd accepted my star and realised that those two people brought me into this world. And we're living in a beautiful world, and it's up to me to live my best life. And those two people gave me that life. So I approached an after adoption agency, and we wrote them a letter, my birth parents. Basically, I wanted to say that I was okay, and if they wanted to meet me, I was open to that. A few weeks later, we got a letter back from their solicitor, and it said, regarding this subject, we do not wish any contact. Further attempts will be ignored. Oh. And the work that I'd done before sending that letter, we were kind of predicting that we would get a negative outcome. And so I was trying to prepare myself for it, but, you know, still it hurt.
Jono, have you forgiven your birth parents for leaving you at the hospital that day and not wanting to make contact? Have you had any closure on that?
Yeah, massively. You know, I think of my birth parents, and it's weird because throughout my life, I've always thought of my birth parents. I thought they've got blonde hair, my mum sings, my dad plays rugby. And they were always in love. And then as I got as a teenager and I was angry, you know, the hair had faded and they got a little bit more wrinkles. And now, as an adult, like I said, those two people gave me life and they brought me into this beautiful world. And for that, I am forever grateful. Through their decision, everything happens for a reason. I met my mum, Jean, and I've just been on this, especially in the last 10 years, I've done so many amazing things, met so many amazing people, and they were my star. There is no anger, there is no negativity towards my birth parents. Just, yeah, thank you for giving me life.
Amazing.
It really is amazing. And you're doing incredible work as well. I mean, can you tell us a little bit about Love Me, Love My Face?
Yeah, so I started having a bit of a media presence.
Yeah.
And over here in the UK, I started doing documentaries, catwalk shows, all sorts of stuff. And all of a sudden, families from all over the UK started reaching out to me. Can you meet my son or my daughter? They've got Treach Collins. They're getting bullied. They're scared. They're worried. And I was like, yeah, let's do it. Mm-hmm. And then all of a sudden, families from all over the world, including Australia, started reaching out. Jono, we would love to see you. We would love for you to come into our children's school and do a talk about Treach Collins, acceptance and self-love. So I worked and saved up my money and flew all over the world. I felt like I was the only one in the world that looked like this. And And I thought if I had had an adult or a role model, if I'd have met somebody, that would have done me the world of good. I get home back to the UK eventually, and I'm in the pub. All the best ideas come in a pub with a pint, right? And I'm sat down with my friends that I've known all my life, and I was like, I want to do more. And they were like, Jono, let's start a charity. So we did, and then the Love Me, Love My Face Foundation was created, and we support children all over the world with Treach Collins or any other craniofacial condition.
It's fantastic.
You are an incredible man, Jono. Your adopted mum, Jean, has done such a brilliant job raising just such a gentleman. And you're an honorary Aussie. You're one of us. You've got the you've got the AFL jersey. You've got the footy behind you. You are welcome anytime. Next time you're down in Australia, we'd love to see you. We'd love to have you in the studio.
I'd love to be back soon.
We'd love you, Jono. You have a fantastic story. Go check out Jono Lancaster online. Positive things every day. One thing you love about yourself every single day, and I love that. Fantastic work.
Good on you,
look
Jono.
Look after yourself.
I love to you all. And again, everybody, what do you love about yourself? You know, get thinking about these things.
All right.
Take care, mate.